welcome everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening from WHO Geneva. We welcome you all from to all the parts in the world where you are to this new webinar on the role of MPDSR in delivering quality care for maternal and newborn health. So this is the third webinar of our series of MPDSR and the maternal and perinatal death surveillance and response. And we're very happy to have you today. So welcome. So I will just give an introduction and introduce myself. So I'm Francesca Palestra, and I'm a technical officer in the maternal health team in the Department of Maternal, Newborn, Child and Adolescent Health and Aging in WHO Geneva. So welcome to everyone again. So we have a full agenda today. We will have first Dr. Samuel Oyeni speaking about the Nigeria experience in integrating MPDSR and quality of care. And then we will have questions and answers facilitated by Dr. Nancy Kidula, a medical officer in reproductive and women's health at the WHO Regional Office for Africa. And then we have Dr. Moon Abdullah, a health system specialist, UNFPA, Eastern and Southern Africa Regional Office. Then we have Ms. Fatima Goar, maternal and newborn health specialist from UNICEF Eastern and Southern Africa Regional Office. Then we will continue with the second part on the introduction and the launch of the WHO knowledge brief on implementation of MPDSR as a strategy to achieve quality of care for maternal and newborn health and considerations for synergies and alignment, presented by Dr. Blerta Maliki, who is the team lead in policy, strategy and programs in WHO Geneva, and then followed by another Q&A. Oops, sorry. So just to say that you can place your questions in the chat box, and when the time comes, we will answer to them, addressing them to the speakers. Now I will give you a brief introduction. So we know that maternal mortality is still high, and in many settings, we have an estimated of 295,000 of maternal deaths. The global maternal mortality ratio is reducing, but we still need to accelerate the progress to get to the SDG target. We can see that we have different regional disparities. As for example, we see in the Africa region, we have an annual current annual average rate of reduction of 2.3%. But in order to get and achieve the SDG target, we will need a reduction of 10.9%. So I think we need to consider this. So I want also to ask to consider the newborn death. So we have an estimated 2.4 million neonatal deaths from estimates on 2019. So it's declining, but still we really need to act fast in order to achieve the SDG targets. And we also need to consider that almost half of under five deaths were during the neonatal period from 2019. Also, stillbirths are an increasing public health problem and global problem, with an estimated 2 million stillbirths. So many stillbirths are invisible. And as you can see from the next slides, where we have the national policies and guidelines that by region, divided by region, that include the maternal and perinatal death surveillance and response, we can really see the disparities between regions that have already included the maternal death reviews in their national policies, and those that still have need to implement and include the stillbirths review, and also the newborn death reviews. So we have a tool, an effective process to really understand what happened behind the death, which is the maternal and perinatal death surveillance and response, which is a continued action cycle of identification, notification, review, and analysis of maternal and perinatal deaths, followed by response to prevent future death. So we know that this as a complex intervention led to the 35% of reduction in inpatient maternal mortality in district hospitals of low-income countries. Just to give a little bit of background, so WHO launched the Maternal Death Surveillance and Response Technical Guidance in 2013. After that, in 2015, we launched the Time to Respond report, which highlighted the status of implementation of this process worldwide. And then after the introduction of making every baby count on how to conduct audits and reviews on neonatal deaths, in 2021, we just in September launched the MPDSR materials to support implementation. So the new materials to support implementation, it's a really practical step-by-step guidance relevant to establish a framework to assess the burden of maternal death, stillbirths, and newborn death in hospitals, including trends in numbers and causes of death, and how to link really the maternal and the perinatal death reviews, which was lacking in the previous guidance. So MPDSR can really improve the quality of maternal and perinatal care. And we will see a presentation from Berta later, who will explain us how to link these two. And also we will have a wonderful presentation from the Nigerian Ministry of Health and see and how really in practice they implemented this. And you can see at the bottom also the link to the resource, and these slides will be shared with all of you. So what's new in the new operational guidance and the new materials? So we have a recommendation on how to conduct joint maternal and perinatal death surveillance and response or reviews and develop a concrete response. A guidance on how to select perinatal death cases, because sometimes there are facilities that are overwhelmed with high rates of mortality and high workload. So how do we really ensure that we have quality reviews? This guidance also gives a step-by-step guidance on how to develop smart recommendation and analyze data and how to monitor and implement these recommendations. We have linkages between MPDSR and quality of care initiatives, and then other topics as how to overcome the blame culture in MPDSR and how to conduct MPDSR in SAR humanitarian settings, and then capacity building materials. Now I would like to introduce Dr. Samuel Oyeni, who is a deputy director and head of Safe Motherhood Branch, MPDSR desk officer from the Monitoring and Evaluation Unit at the Department of Family Health, Federal Ministry of Health in Nigeria. And with him, I also would like to welcome Dr. Salma Ibrahim Anas, who is the director of the Department of Family Health in Nigeria, and also Professor Oladapo Shitu, who is the Provost of College of Medicine, Federal University of Health Science, Otoku, Benue State, Nigeria. So thank you very much, you all, to really be present and share with us your experience on implementation. And over to you, Dr. Samuel Oyeni, with your presentation. Thank you.
Okay, good afternoon. Okay, thank you very much. These are the presentation outline we'll be looking at during this presentation. I want to appreciate the Honorable Minister of Health and the Director of Family Health for the efforts so far that we've been able to look into this concept and the implementation we have done so far, especially at the state level. Next slide. Okay, the situation analysis from Nigeria. We've been having a slow decline in the maternal mortality ratio, but the target, we've not reached there yet. The progressive slow rate is slow. If you look at it from 1990, as a 2018 NDHS, we're at 556. And the achievement within the 2013 and 2018 that we started the MPDSR, we've been able to look at maternal and perinatal deaths. And when you look at the child mortality rate, both in from neonatal, infant, and under five, there is no much decline. And we have looked at it, if we should bring child health into the MPDSR so that we can now have the child death audit within the MPDSR so that we can flow with it and see how the contribution could be for us to have an acceptable decline in the in this child mortality rate. Next slide. So our scope of implementation so far, for our MPDSR program, we have a national steering committee, and all the 36 states and FCTs have a coordination committee in place, functional and running, and they are reporting data. All the secondary facility also are also reporting in all the 36 and FCT on MPDSR program. For federal hospitals, we have 54 that are conducting MPDSR through the MPD for QED, a program also launched by WHO. We have 15 out of 37 states that has commenced primary health care MPDSR implementation through the agencies, and now 10 out of 37 states are reporting on community MPDSR through the same agency. But the status of QOC program, we have 112 learning sites. It must have increased by now, and about 12 to 13 states is already implementing QOC program relative to what we've been able to do since 2015 on MPDSR in terms of scope and coverage. Next slide. So what are the rationale? Number one is a recommendation from the global network that we integrate. And apart from that, when we started the quality of care, many states, many actors in MPDSR implementation were calling for integration. And that was presented by the Director of Family Health to the Honorable Minister, who directed that the integration be carried out, integrating QOC with MPDSR. Because if you look at it, they have the same goal, looking at maternal and newborn health. But we are bringing the child components to it, looking at our health indices and the child mortality rate, and see the contribution and the efforts that MPDSR can bring to support the reduction of child mortality in Nigeria. So they are of the same goal. And also MPDSR is a strategic and evidence-based approach to improve QOC in maternal, newborn, child health. It will also help to scale up QOC program implementation because MPDSR, in terms of scope and coverage, in terms of coordination, we already have the committees in place at all levels of healthcare, primary, secondary, and tertiary level at the state and national. So that can be leveraged on to quickly scale up the implementation. And looking at the same human resource for health in terms of specialty, that we are using in the coordination, in the implementation, similar human resource for health to move the two forward. So the same target audience, the impact indicators are also the same. So we need to now use one implementation plan so that we can better the outcome that we are all looking at. If all these rationale are the same in terms of human resource for health and others. And also for effective and efficient use of time and human resources, looking at the similarity in the coordination of implementation. Partners are also the same, and they're calling out at frequent times for meetings for individual program as a parallel program. It's very tiring, effort and time wasting. Also, we now have a legislation on MPDSR, which has also brought in place and make sure that we have QOC. In the bill, the MPDSR bill legislation has just been passed last week into law, waiting for president to assent to that. So National Assembly has passed the MPDSR bill, and that can be used to leverage to ensure quality of care. Also, to ensure sustainability of QOC, leveraging on the bill, as I've said, that is awaiting. Next slide. So when we look at the relationship between MPDSR and the delay model in achieving quality improvement, quality of care processes, you will find out MPDSR look at the three delays at a go, and through the recommendations made from maybe the highest to the least in the target, we look at recommendation in terms of delay one during review meetings, in terms of transportation to care during review meetings, and in terms of quality received, in terms of standard setting at the facility. So when you look at it, MPDSR look at the three delays at a go in making recommendations to effect changes and responses. And the community MPDSR, we focus more on the delay one, delay two, at the community level to make sure that facility are reached, and why we have the facility MPDSR to ensure quality of care at the facility level. So that is where the maternal, newborn, and child health quality of care is well needed in terms of facility MPDSR, that we ensure quality of care or quality improvement at that level. And next slide. So the concept of integration, I want to say here that we have our health policy and we have the health plan, which we call the National Health Strategic Development Plan 2. In that plan, it is stated that we have one coordination, one MRE, and one plan for programs that have the same goal to be able to achieve the outcome. And in that plan, we have pillars, nine pillars. Within the pillars, the reproductive, maternal, newborn, adolescent, and elderly, plus nutrition, there is in priority two. So the plan has directed the coordination of programs that has to do with continuum of care be integrated and be coordinated with one plan and one coordination body. So we are leveraging on this health policy and plan to be able to integrate the quality of care program and the MPDSR program. If you look at it from this concept, MPDSR mainly identifies problems true death review, near misses review. And once those things are investigated, responses are brought up through review, or recommendations are brought up through review for action to prevent future occurrences. And it is expected that the maternal, newborn, and child death quality of care team that is meant to look at this problem and solve it, we pick up the recommendations made from the review of deaths and review of near misses. And once that is done, the circle continues, and it is expected that that will help to reduce maternal mortality. And if in the process of quality of care at the facility level, there is another death is passed to the MPDSR, which review again, and the circle continues. But this is done looking at one coordination body, one MIE, and one plan that we have. So this is the concept of integration that we have put forward, and the state ready to work with it. Next slide. So this is just the concept also in terms of implementation structures of MPDSR and QOC. If you look at it, the MPDSR is standing like a tripod on three programs, the surveillance, the health information system, and the quality improvement. And this is done by routine identification, notification, quantification that leads to review. And it is expected at the review, recommendations are made, and that will lead to a response. So it is expected that the response is done by the quality of care team that can also bring back information and report to the one committee that is set up. So at the point of quantification, the desk officer, the medical record officer, takes the data, and those data in Nigeria presently, we have the Nigerian Obstetric Quality Assurance platform, electronic platform that we use to analyze mortality data. Is presently being used at community, primary health care, and all the secondary facility, they are reporting. And not too long, we are using MPD for QED database at the tertiary institution to take data. So when you look at it, this data is now being used for reporting. And that reporting that we are doing, the reporting we have by looking at the PDSA circle of quality of care, and that will lead to quality improvement. So when you look at it, the two of them will eventually meet at quality improvement if implemented together. Next slide. So at the national level, after looking at it, what we are looking at national level, we be merging to the MPDSR steering committee, who has been since 2015 with a quality of care TWG. If the same partners, the same participant, the same committee members are operating the two. So when this is merged based on the directive of the Minister of Health, the Secretariat is at the Director of Family Health Office, where we had head of coordinating units. So the focal person of QOC and MPDSR will be feeding into the Director of Family Health through the head of coordinating unit. So when this committee merged, we have three subcommittee in line with the health policy and plan that we should use one coordinating body. So we have the RAMCA technical subcommittee, and we have the advocacy subcommittee, and the accountability data knowledge subcommittee. So these three subcommittee will be looking at activity of both the MPDSR and the QOC. So there will not be, in terms of QOC having its own three committee working parallel, with MPDSR having its own 3 subcommittee also working parallel. So they'll be able to look at the activity of both MPDSR and KOC together and report back to the Honorable Minister through the steering committee that has been moved or charged together or merged together, headed by the Honorable Minister based on his approval. So this is just the diagrammatic coordination in terms of national level. Next slide. So at the state level, health in Nigeria is at the residual list. We call it residual list. It's there because national cannot give directive for the state in terms of health. So if directive is even given, we are just facilitating it, advocating it for states to implement as agreed, but it's not imposing on the state because of the cultural, geographical, social, and religious differences in Nigeria. So because of that, state at liberty to take directive as advised by the national. So based on this, the state, in terms of state level, we have the there'll be a merger also, and the commissioner will be at the ends of affair. Contrary to what presently before now, where a Sogon member is the chairman and a PAM member is the co-chair. So there'll be merger, and that merger will be headed by the chief executive of the state. So this is how the state will stand. And based on the meeting's review of that, from that merger, recommendations will be sent to the KOC subcommittee that will now lead to KOC improvement. And information is will now go back again to this committee. So the committee will be looking also at the activities of MPDSR and KOC at the same time. Federal government has also planning as a structure to make sure that we have the Department of Family Health in all the 36 states, the RAMCA coordination in all the states. So the 3 subcommittee also will be at the state level, working to look at the activity of the 2 programs. So when you look at it at the national, at the state, you have a similar committee. They can coordinate, they can link, they can network based on activities and supervise similarly. Next slide. So at the facility level, we have 3 healthcare level. We have the primary, the secondary, and the tertiary. At the primary level, the in charge of the primary health facility will be the leader of the committee at that level. At the secondary level, the chief medical officer and the principal medical officer will be the leader of the team, looking at the merger between MPDSR and KOC. As we are before now, there are a lot of facility with QI team, MPDSR team. They are not speaking to one another. So the response is very low. As we are speaking, response is low. So the few that review that we are having, the response to those recommendations are low. So that, because they are not speaking before now. So there is a need for the 2 of them to have knowledge of what is going on in QOC and in MPDSR activity. So the rest, if that is done, response will be higher. So for tertiary facility also, we also have the MPDSR and the MPD for QED serving as the quality of care team at that level. Also, the minister has also approved that this team should work together so that the team that we have can look at those activity together. So at that facility, once that is reviewed and the recommendations are made, the response component of it will be taken up. The little difference at the facility is from the tertiary, where the CMAC is a statutory responsibility to ensure quality of care at tertiary level. So the committee will be under the CMAC, and that is what is in the MPDSR bill. So the MNCH POC team that is formed at the tertiary works with the MPDSR. So the two of them match together, will be under the CMAC. And once that are reviewed, they will also look at activity of POC. Responses that is needed from the recommendations are taken up through the head of facility. And there'll be data management from the data that is being collated. So the two officers, the desk officer for MPDSR and the desk officer for QOC at that point, we respectively, the QOCFP will be the response officer. And it is expected with response that is being taken up by QOC team under the CMAG, will lead to QOC improvement. There is a need to merge for us to be able to increase the response component. And it's the response component that will lead to quality of care. So the two will complement one another, knowing what is going on in the two programs. And that will facilitate the outcome that we all need. And there will be three subcommittees at that level also, feeding into the head of the facility that will be able to also look at the two program together as a team. Next slide. So the coordination mechanism that we have put in place for the merged committee at each of the level, national, state, and primary healthcare level, all of them will be working under the director of family health at this level. And that we also transmit to the steering committee. And in the steering committee, we have all the stakeholders, the partners, which are similarly the same composition before now in terms of QOC and MPDSR. So they will be feeding to the steering committee and be looking at the activity of QOC and debt review so that decisions are taken together and the actions are taken together and the response that is coming from it will lead to the quality improvement that we all want. Next slide. So these are just the data management for the two. In terms of mortality, we have the NOQA network that we are using to collect data for mortality, maternal, perinatal, and childbirth review in terms of identification, notification. It does notification, quantification. In fact, this platform can generate reports by clicking of a button. It will generate 1 year report, develop the graph for us, the table, the graph for us. So that's what we've been using. We have used it to present to the top management committee in the Federal Ministry of Health to the minister. When we are also defending the bill, we also use the data from this to defend it. The second platform we're also looking at is the MPD for QD platform. At presently, it's at the tertiary institution alone. It is expected that quality of care platform at that level will go down the level of care to collect data for quality of care indicators so that the two platforms can now be used to compare and look at where the area where we're performing and be able to take decision together, looking at the two platforms together. Next slide. So the expected accomplishment, we expect that there will be reduction, accelerated reduction of maternal newborn child. If this, as we are trying to integrate both the MPDSR and POC in Nigeria that have started in few states, they made presentation during the guideline review we just done in terms of review. One coordination steering committee, that's what we are looking at, so that there will be one coordination looking at the two, one annual operational plan. The M&E plan will also be looked at in terms of one M&E plan, a joint annual report that can feed into one another. It will be very good to look at mortality and quality of care indicators and be able to make a decision on it. Supportive supervision can be one, so that we won't have to supervise MPDSR separate, supervise a quality of care program separate at all level. After all of them are for one outcome. Then training will be one. We are looking, I already started a few states where they do training for like a week, 6 days. They will first take MPDSR training, like 3-4 days, and they will enter QOC training for the remaining 3 days. So the same people will be able to do train together. We can look at putting this training together and be able to move from MPDSR to QOC training. The same participant, the same time, the same people, the same facilitator. So this will enhance and be able to use the same people to move the two programs together. It will improve professional performance, enhance professional of quality, looking at the continuum of care, so that we'll be able to look at the continuum of care together. And that way is enhancing our health indices. It also enhances community participation, government and other stakeholders in looking at the two together as one coordination body. Next slide. So, way forward, based on what our experience, lesson learned from the states that have implemented and what we're already doing at state level, facility level, there will be a reconstitution of the MPDS steering committee that will be able to look at the merger together at the national level. And that we consider the MPDSRB that has just been passed into law and the spirit of integration at the national level, learning from what is already taking place at few states and the health facility as presented to us. We are looking at complete the creation of Department of Family Health and the RMCA plus N coordination body in all the states of Nigeria. Moving forward is ongoing, and that is expected to complete because it's a structure. And with that structure, states that have done this, they have moved forward in the integration that we are looking at. So there is a need for all the states to integrate under a good, an harmonized structure that is existing according to health plan and according to the health policies in Nigeria. So there also need for situation analysis. Baseline in 2015, but we will not be able to secure a fund to do the status of implementation. And that can, at the same time, we can use the status of implementation to do for QOC programs as a baseline in all the state, so that we can be looking at the two together. Moving forward, there will be national and sub-national orientation. As we have now, few states are just doing it. So there is a need to put all the states together, orientate them, and build their capacity. We'll continue to enter data through the platform that we already have. Government is taking the two platform over from the hub. So we are set in terms of data. We have what it takes to analyze, to enter, collate, and use the data. We're already presenting data using this platform at the top management meeting with the Honorable Minister in taking a lot of decisions. So that is already in place and we'll continue to do that. So the structure that is needed for this integration at national, at state, and at facility level, we're already there. And we'll be able to use the lesson learned from the states that are already piloting who, based on what I've presented, to move forward. Then monitoring and supervision will also help to quickly make consideration for changes where necessary. Next. So for in conclusion, we'll find out that integrating the implementation of the QOC program and MPDSR since one is like a strategy that can help to achieve the other. We balance and appraise the extent to which individual patients at facilities were served or not served. You can review it, review what happens to these patients, and with specified standard of care as given by WHO in terms of standard, it will really reveal a lot of substandard practices, and you will learn from it in moving forward within the facility. When we look at what we have done and the standards set by WHO in each of these areas, we'll be able to remedy and lead to improvement in quality of care and services, and preserves the life of mother, newborn, and children. And this can brought up or bring about balance in quality of care as we get receive each other facilities. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Onyeni, for the presentation. It was really, really informative. And thank you everyone who posted their question in the chat box. So we will now start the question and answers facilitated by Dr. Nancy Kidula, Dr. Muna Abdullah, and Ms. Fatima Goar. So like this, Dr. Onyeni could answer your questions and or his also colleagues. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Francesca. Thank you, colleagues. I would like to hand over to Fatima to start us off with the first group of questions, and then Muna will ask the next group of questions. Over to you, Fatima.
Thank you so much, Nancy. Thank you, Dr. Samuel, for that enlightening presentation. I think it is, and I could see from chat box that it is really what the response which we are getting, it's really mesmerizing, as colleagues are really, they're liking the approach of integration. There are a few questions, and I'll share a few of them with you, and then rest will be shared by Mona and Nancy. So the first question, and it's very important one, is how will the MPDSR bill strengthen MPDSR and quality of care implementation at the state level? That's one. And then second is this at the integration which you just talked about, is it at PHC and community level too? Let me stop here.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Muna, let him answer too, and then you go ahead.
Okay.
Yeah. Dr. Samuel, is it okay?
Yes, you want me to respond to these two?
These two, and then Muna will ask you the other question.
Okay, thank you very much. I have my colleagues online. When I respond, if there are additions, please you will allow them to have one or two additions. I have Professor Oladapo Shitu and my other colleagues in the office. Professor Oladapo Shitu is one of the major funder of MPDSR in Nigeria. He's like an advisor to MPDSR implementation in Nigeria. Thank you very much. So the first one is, how will MPDSR and QOC be strengthened at the state level? We have mentioned that at the state level, there will be merging of the two coordination body at the state level, and it will be chaired by the Honorable Commissioner, the Chief Executive Officer. And it's very important because of the response component of it, I have examples of a lesson learned from states, but because of our time, that Commissioner came in to have one thing or the other in terms of response that improve quality of care at that level. So there will be merger at that level that will strengthen it once the head of the state health institutions is the head and is attending to meetings and data is presented using the platform. The platform is already in all the states of the Federation. So that will strengthen the two of them. So that is what we are backing on, using the policymaker as the head of the merger, unlike what we had before. And that will strengthen the implementation of activity and response and quality improvement at that level. For the PHC and community level, presently, I'm not aware of any QC activity or program for engagement, for community engagement going on. But for primary healthcare level, where we have already have an agency that is responsible for implementation at that level in Nigeria, we already have 15 states trained, and they have gone back to do a step down training for the PHC committee. So in the PHC committee, in a PHC where the human resource is not even enough, you may find in Africa or Nigeria specifically, maybe 2, 3, 4 health workers, and they have other things to do. So they'll be able to look at the two together. It's going to be one coordination at that level also. So that's what we are looking at. But for community, we've not really experienced in terms of quality of care, program set aside for community. But we have community MPDSR, and the community MPDSR we have also uses the existing structure of the community, where the World Development Committee chairman is the chair of the community MPDSR. So they will look at issues surrounding delay one, issues surrounding delay two. So it's going to be one coordination body also at that level to bring quality into what is going on at the community in terms of referral, prompt referral, prompt decision making to reach the facility. So I want to say any of my colleagues online that may want to maybe add one or two things to these questions. If there are no, we can move on to the second set of questions.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much, Dr. Samuel. This question is about data. Are the data management platforms available for access by partners? Over to you.
Okay. Yes, for partners is available, but for now, we are not giving, or we have not given password, username for partners. We have only given to all the states of the Federation, all the secondary facility, they have the password, they have the access to this, all the tertiary institutions, they have access to it, but not yet for partners. It's going to move, get to partners. Why we are holding on, number one, is that we are expanding the platform to be able to cover community in terms of expansion. Number two, we are bringing the hub. Presently, the platform is supported, funded, and established by Rotary International with collaboration with the Federal Ministry of Health. So the hub is still in Germany, and Rotary is doing great work to support us. So the federal government has directed, has also released funds to bring this up down to Nigeria. All this, everything is set. We have, is ongoing already to bring the hub. So by the time the hub and everything is now within Nigeria, then we'll be able to now give this access to partners. But that doesn't mean partners cannot access through the state HMIS officer, the access code given to state, the access code given to all the secondary facility, the access code given to the tertiary, 54 tertiary institutions, the access code given to national primary health care agencies. So we have these access codes according to the level of health care. So partners that need data can come to any of these levels and seek the data that they want. They will be given.
Sorry for the interruption, Dr. Onyeni. Thank you so much for your answer. I'm so sorry. We are running very, very late. We still have a last presentation before to finish in 10 minutes. This is such a rich discussion, and over to you, Nancy, to close up the questions and answers, because then we will have Blerta's presentation. We will be able also to answer to all the questions and answers by email, and we will forward them to you, Dr. Onyeni. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I think we can carry forward the remaining questions to the next part. There are a lot of questions, as you can see in the chat, and I think, Doctor, you can answer some of them in the chat, and we will pick a few more to put in the next question and answer session. Thank you, and back to you, Francesca.
Thank you very much, Nancy, and over to you, Blerta. Thank you very much for your presentation. Over to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much to our colleagues from Nigeria for sharing their very rich experience in implementation of maternal perinatal death surveillance and response system and the linkages with quality of care. In WHO, in collaboration with our partners, UNICEF, UNFPA, the implementing partners of USAID and more for the past 4 years, we have engaged with 10 countries in which we are implementing and supporting the government to implement quality of care from a systems perspective with a focus on maternal, newborn and child health. In this implementation, we have learned a lot. And one of the aspects that we want to share today with everyone, it is the direct links between MPDSR and quality of care. And our colleagues in Nigeria and Dr. Samuel already shared with us the different aspects of connectivities, but also challenges in this implementation. In the last year, we have summarized this experience across many countries and prepared what it is going to be introduced today and launched today in the WHO website. You'll see the link in the chat. The knowledge brief on implementation of MPDSR as a strategy to achieve quality of care for maternal and newborn health. And then we'll share some considerations for synergies and applications. Quality of care is a very important aspect and determinant of morbidity and mortality. Over 60% of neonatal deaths and more than half of maternal deaths can be prevented by providing good quality care. WHO has launched the set of standards, quality of care standards for service delivery in health facilities during childbirth, looking at the mother and baby. And then recently we launched the standards on sick and small newborns, as well as we're completing the scope of quality of care standards by launching the and producing the quality of care standards for pediatric care. This is very important because if we don't have standards for care, we won't be able to say that we are really delivering quality care and then leading to that improvement in outcomes. Next slide, please. Concurrently, WHO is working with member states to institutionalize quality of care. The National Quality Policy and Strategy document clearly states the types of quality of care interventions organized in 4 large buckets around systems interventions, IPC, so infection prevention and control, programmatic interventions and community and family. Within the programmatic interventions, the MPDSR and death audits are highlighted as 2 key types of activities and interventions which influence and determine quality of care. So implementation of the MNH quality of care standards is doable and it will be achieved only if we move or if we complete this package of interventions with what is needed. So allow me now to go a bit more in depth into the MPDSR and the MPDSR cycle. MPDSR, as we already discussed in the first part of this webinar, is an important part of quality of care intervention. tracking numbers and understanding the causes of death is key for improving maternal and perinatal and neonatal survival. And therefore, systematic analysis of mortality trends and the factors that contribute to individual deaths can help uncover quality of care and health systems deficit and inspire local solutions. Next slide, please. There are a number of synergies and linkages between the implementation of MPDSR and the broader efforts to improve MNCH quality of care. The MPDSR continuous action cycle relies on teams to collect and analyze information on when, where, and why women and babies die, and define actions to prevent similar deaths. Comprehensive MPDSR generates quality information on leading causes of maternal and perinatal deaths and important common contributors to these deaths. This information can advise on the prioritization of responses as part of MPDSR process and can also help inform prioritization of improvement aims by quality of care managers and teams. And we already heard this during the Nigeria presentation and experience. MPDSR often lacks systematic implementation and monitoring of responses and analysis of whether responses are yielding desired effects. So integrating MPDSR with a broader quality of care efforts for maternal and newborn health has the potential to enhance follow-up, implementation, and monitoring of responses at facilities at national and national levels. Now, let's see how two countries, Ethiopia and Nigeria, and I think I'll skip Nigeria because we already went in depth, are using MPDSR to improve quality of care for mothers and newborn in facilities and vice versa. So the Ethiopia experience, which is around aligning and synergizing quality of care efforts with MPDSR. In Ethiopia, MPDSR and maternal newborn quality improvement processes have developed alongside one another and have benefited from each other's successes. MPDSR identifies the factors leading to death and informs recommendations, which are then implemented and monitored by quality of care teams. The Plan, Do, Study, Act, the PDSA cycle used by quality of care as part of quality improvement cycles, is featured in both MPDSR and quality of care processes. The PDSA planning phase draws upon problems identified by the MPDSR committees. The doing, studying, could you please keep the yes, that's good. So the doing, studying, and acting phases of PDSA, which belong to the response aspect of MPDSR, and are carried out by quality of care teams. Now, at the national level, the emphasis is on leadership, coordination of linkages. The national level determines priorities based on data, design strategies, and guides implementation of quality of care. At the subnational level, maternal newborn quality of care and MPDSR working groups interact and use the information generated by MPDSR to inform quality improvement priorities and actions at the subnational level. And this is something that our colleague in Nigeria already highlighted as a gap or as a challenge for implementation. And at the facility level, the quality leadership team oversees quality of care initiatives and has similar memberships as the MPDSR team, important for the synergy. So specific multidisciplinary quality improvement teams are established for every single project, including for those projects that are informed by the MPDSR data. Next slide, please. The next slide gives you a summary. Next slide. Of Nigeria, we already went into details. Important is to see the alignment between the quality of care and MPDSR committees implementation, and then everything that was already described in the previous discussion by Dr. Samuel. That is important because we want to have a full alignment between systems, that is information system, data systems, and so on. I just want to mention one more. It's important to have MPDSR and quality of care aligned in the public and private sector. Next slide, please. So the knowledge brief that we have put together provides some practical considerations for strengthening synergies and linkages between MPDSR and quality of care structures. The structures, first of all, the structures to support MNH quality of care and MPDSR, although vary across countries, it is important that all of us, so policymakers and implementers, try to reduce silos and improve synergies to achieve better alignment and thus reduce inefficiencies as well as enhance results. So options for strengthening synergies and alignment at the national level include national MNH program managers in collaboration with members of national MPDSR and quality of care committees or working groups can help to strengthen these linkages and mechanisms. And how to go about it? That could be by including MPDSR as core quality of care intervention in a national maternal newborn health strategy, by including MPDSR role structures and processes in the maternal newborn health quality of care strategy and guidance documents, or using common systems to monitor and report data to inform priorities for actions, evaluating and aligning recommendations. MPDSR findings that are shared and discussed at the national level may also help to identify which districts or regions may need extra support for MPDSR quality of care more generally. At the subnational level, be that district or regional and facility levels, when feasible, aligning MPDSR structures and implementation with broader MNH quality of care efforts and structures will promote linkages and integration across subnational, district, and facility levels. At this level, MPDSR committee can help shed light of the most common causes of maternal and perinatal mortality and contributing factors to local settings. This information can help subnational quality of care committees and managers prioritize improvement aims based on local disease burden. At subnational level, MPDSR quality of care committees may collaborate close or may combine depending on existing structures and priorities. And within smaller subnational administrative areas, MNCH quality of care and MPDSR roles might be combined, resulting in integrating by default. In the facility level, especially for small PHC facilities, we recommend that MPDSR and quality of care activities may be better managed by a single team, and in this model can be replicated in facilities across sectors, so public and private sector. Next slide. There is a number of questions that we still have in relation to implementation. I'll not go in depth in relation to these research questions. Many of them require engagement with implementation research, implementers and academia scientists, so we can start having some of the answers on how do we optimize and ensure that we do improve quality of care for maternal and newborn health by taking into considerations all the possible interventions, and MPDSR remains one of the core interventions, be that from a data, from a quality perspective, but also from an implementation that engages both professionals, communities, and all of those who are concerned by the service delivery. Please look at the knowledge brief. Let us know your feedback. That would be very appreciated. And I'll hand it over to Nancy and the facilitators team for the closure. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Blatter, for that. Just to alert everyone that the link to the document that Blatter is talking about has been put in the chat, the knowledge brief, and also on this final slide that is being shown by Francesca. We don't seem to have new questions. And so we will ask Samuel just one old question, even though there is minimum time. How have you dealt with the legal and ethical implications of MPDSR when you are integrating with quality of care? Just 1 minute, very fast response, Samuel, then back to Francesca.
Okay, thank you very much. The ethical implication of MPDSR is no name, no blame. We still stick to that according to our guidelines. If there are issues, we have a committee of inquiry outside MPDSR at all to do that. And that is in line with the MPDSR bill, which when issues in terms of legal implications come up, there will be a committee of inquiry. It's no name, no blame in terms of report during review. So that has helped us to manage the two very well. The MPDSR bill focuses on reporting, majorly reporting, reporting responses, reviews, reporting rates that are make it compulsory to facilitate the implementation to achieve the quality of care. So that is what we are doing presently. Thank you. So I don't know if Professor Shitu has anything to add.
In the interest of time, I think we can hold the further comments. The secretariat will respond to these questions and share the responses with the registered participants. Okay. In interest of time, let me hand back over to Francesca.
Thank you very much, Nancy, and thank you very much, Dr. Onyini, to answer all these questions. We will review all the questions that have not been answered and forward them to you. Like this, you can answer to the participants or to add any further information. So here I put some links on the knowledge brief, as Nancy already mentioned, our WHO website. You can find all these slides. These slides will be sent to you, and you will be able to find them also on the Quality of Care Network website. And please, so any further question you have, you can always email me. There is the email on the bottom of the slide. So thank you very much for your presence and for your interest. It was a very engaging session. Thank you, Nancy. Thank you, Mona. And thank you, Fatima. Thank you, everyone, for their participation and support. So we look forward to seeing you to our next webinar. Bye. Have a nice day.
Bye-bye, everyone. Thank you. Thank you, Francisca.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Thank you and goodbye.
Thank you very much. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Well done, Dr. Lini.